The arrival of the Rolling Stones at Dallas Love Field Saturday night wasn't a very good indication of things to come. When the big star-studded red, white, and blue jet landed and taxied toward the hangar, the 80-person entourage on board far outnumbered the handful of people waiting to greet the group. That may have been the way they wanted it. Security was tight, and the Stones were whisked away in station wagons to unknown destinations. As it turned out, two of the Stones weren't aboard that plane. They'd chosen to drive in from their Friday night concert in Memphis. But along the way, they were stopped by Arkansas police. Guitarist Keith Richard was charged with reckless driving and illegal possession of a knife, and a traveling companion was charged with illegal possession of a drug. The two Stones spent 7 hours talking with police, then were released and flown to Dallas in plenty of time for the concert. 60,000 tickets were sold in advance for the Dallas concert at $10 each. Other fans bought their tickets at the gate for $12.50. They wasted little time getting inside. By mid-morning, much of the stadium was filled, with the floor jammed with people. By noon, expressways leading to Fair Park were packed with cars. Several autos were abandoned along the way because of overheated engines, or perhaps because no better parking places could be found. Stadium security was tight, with 75 Dallas police, augmented by a private security force of 160 red-shirted guards. All alcoholic beverages were banned in anticipation of the mid-90s heat, and almost 300 volunteer doctors and nurses were on hand to distribute salt tablets and treat the inevitable cases of heat prostration and sunstroke. To help beat the heat, a sprinkler was stationed at one end of the field, and concertgoers were invited to cool off, slipping and sliding across plastic mats. The Dallas concert was just one stop in the group's three-month, 58-performance tour, in which it's estimated they'll entertain 1.5 million people. And with all those ticket sales, perhaps put a dent in America's balance of payments, with all that money going overseas. Dave Cassidy, Channel 8 News.